Who were the sauropod dinosaurs? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, we are going to take a look at one of the most bizarre and amazing groups of dinosaurs, the long-necked dinosaurs belonging to the Sauropoda branch of the dinosaur tree. The Sauropoda were large herbivores, plant-eating dinosaurs, which are members of the saurischian lizard-hipped dinosaurs. The Sauropoda arose during the Middle Jurassic, and they lived until the end of the Cretaceous. They were the most diverse during the late Jurassic and early Cretaceous, with a fossil record on every continent except Antarctica. I thought I would highlight some of the lesser known Sauropoda dinosaurs in this video, as well as some of the mysteries of this group. The oldest sauropod dinosaurs are known from southern Africa, such as the dinosaur Atinitritus from the late Triassic and early Jurassic, as well as the dinosaur Vulcodon. These were smaller, sort of elephant-sized, fully quadrupedal, long-necked dinosaurs. However, most of the early Jurassic forms are poorly known, and no skull is known of a sauropod dinosaur until the Middle Jurassic. So did you know that sauropod dinosaurs, some of them had tail clubs? The late Jurassic dinosaur Shunosaurus from Asia exhibited an ossified tail with tail spikes. Now this long-necked dinosaur would have swung this long tail with these very powerful strokes with a bony club at the end. This would deter any carnivore from trying to feast on it. Now the tail spines were slightly different than found in Stegosaurus, but having a baseball bat-sized tail club at the end of a very long tail is a very nice defense against predators. The early and middle Jurassic Spinophorosaurus from North Africa also had a tail club with small spines. Now, Spinophorosaurus was discovered in Niger by Spanish paleontologists, and the discovery was amazing in how well preserved the skeleton was. The animal was a massive-sized creature, already on the path to being truly large-sized dinosaurs by the Middle Jurassic. Now, one of the weirdest sauropod dinosaurs is the super long-necked dinosaur, Mamenchisaurus, from the late Jurassic of Asia. With a massively long neck, these dinosaurs grew to gigantic sizes. The neck was 43 to 49 feet long, an astonishingly long neck. Now this freakish dinosaur is on display at the Xinjiang Museum in China, with a number of casts that are on display at various museums around the world. Now, Mamenchisaurus was a thick-necked dinosaur, which resembles the super tall dinosaur, Giraffatitan, from Tanzania in Africa, which is on display at the Berlin Museum in Europe. Now, Giraffatitan had longer forelimbs and a very long upright neck. Another African dinosaur is a much smaller Nigersaurus from North Africa. It's displayed this weird nipping teeth with this sort of bizarre, I don't know, like longmore-like skull. In South America, one smaller sauropod from the Cretaceous, Amargasaurus, had long neural spines along the cervical vertebrae with a spike-like ridge that extended down its back. All of these sauropods attest to their weird and unusual anatomy. Now there's one place in the world where the largest and most diverse group of sauropod dinosaurs are known from, and that is the late Jurassic rock formation called the Morrison Formation, which is a layer of mudstone and sandstones that extends across eastern Utah, Colorado, from New Mexico up to northern Wyoming. Now, the Morrison Formation is home to 21, 25 or so species of long-necked dinosaurs, depending on which classification you use. It's the home to the famous Brontosaurus or Apatosaurus, as well as a host of other supersized giants. What made this particular formation rich in large, long-necked dinosaurs is a bit of a mystery. In the lower portion of the formation, we have Haplocanthosaurus. This is an elephant-sized dinosaur, which is known from western Colorado and northeastern Utah. Now, about 10 years ago, a skeleton was discovered near Vernal when a gas pipeline was being constructed across this rich dinosaur formation. The bones of this Haplocanthosaurus are exhibited at the local museum in town. No skull is known of Haplocanthosaurus yet. Another common dinosaur from the Morrison Formation is the extremely long, whipped-tailed sauropod Diplodocus, which is known from some amazingly complete specimens. Now, Diplodocus had a long, narrow skull and a long body and long tail and long legs with shorter forelegs and this really, really extremely long tail. Now, some specimens of Diplodocus have been claimed to be the largest sauropod ever. Apatosaurus, which is also known as Brontosaurus, although there's been some suggestion that the holotype of Brontosaurus is unique enough to re-erect the genus, is a large, long-necked dinosaur that differs from Diplodocus primarily in having the cervical vertebrae, which are wider with longer processes. Now, the skull, which was unknown for many, many years, resembles Diplodocus in being narrow with pencil-like teeth. In looking at the skull, the way you tell Diplodocus from Apatosaurus is that Apatosaurus has a wider skull than the more narrow Diplodocus. A slightly more common sauropod dinosaur from the Morrison Formation is the large but not giant sauropod Camarasaurus, which, unlike Apatosaurus and Diplodocus, has a very boxy-shaped skull with more dagger-like teeth which have these interesting ridges on them. The skull is also very open in its morphology, and the body has slightly longer forelegs. Now, a nearly complete skeleton of a juvenile was discovered near Vernal in 1922, which included a 100% complete skeleton, which is really, really rare. Now, the fossil's on display in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania at the Carnegie Museum. The early 1925 reconstruction has this animal dragging its tail, but in life it likely held its tail stiffly behind as it walked, as no tail drag marks are known from any sauropod trackways that are known. Brachiosaurus is another Morrison dinosaur, and it's known from the same layer of rocks in both Utah and Colorado. Now, Brachiosaurus had a more boxy skull like Camarasaurus and had forelegs that were much longer than the hind legs. Brachiosaurus resembles Giraffatitan in stance with those longer forelegs. Now, the list of sauropod dinosaurs from the Morrison Formation is really long. And one of the biggest challenges is that since sauropod dinosaurs are just so giant and big and just really hard to excavate out of the rock, that they tend to be known from isolated fragmentary skeletons. And there's also the added pressure on paleontologists to name new species when many of these specimens might be juveniles or they might be just larger adults. So it is a naming quandary. But we do know that a number of these sauropod dinosaurs are well known enough to exhibit clear morphological differences. So what made the Morrison Formation such a rich time and place for these giant long-necked dinosaurs? Well, we really don't know. Sauropod dinosaurs lived onward beyond the Jurassic into the Cretaceous. In the Cedar Mountain formation of Utah, several sauropod specimens are known, including Apatosaurus, which is known from near Vernal, Utah, and was excavated and described by paleontologists at BYU in 2010. The specimen includes a very remarkable skull, which closely resembles Brachiosaurus from the underlying Morrison Formation. Now, during the early Cretaceous of North America, the sauropoda became less diverse, likely due to the new competition with some of these larger ornithischian dinosaurs like the ceratopsian, the horned dinosaurs. But in the southern continent, such as in South America, the sauropoda continued to exhibit increased diversity and larger sizes, and these later sauropods are called the titanosaurids. And they had one additional feature. They had osteoderms, those bony scutes, and they covered the flanks of these sauropod dinosaurs. One of the smallest of the titanosaurs is the small Malagasy dinosaur Rapetosaurus from the late Cretaceous of Madagascar. But the really big titanosaurids are known from South America. This includes the giant Dreadnoughtius and the new giant unnamed titanosaur discovered by Jose Luis Carbondino and Diego Pol, which is on display in New York at the American Museum. These South American sauropods during the later Cretaceous were giants. I mean, they're really big. And they appear to rival the size of the late Jurassic dinosaurs from North America. Now, sauropod dinosaurs from the Cretaceous are also known from Asia and Australia and Africa and Europe and in South America, of course. But during the latest Cretaceous, only one sauropod is known from North America, the large Alamosaurus, which only ranged northward into Utah, but was more common in Texas and New Mexico. Now, despite amazing late Cretaceous dinosaurs known from Montana and Canada, no late Cretaceous sauropod is known from these northern sites. So it's likely that Alamosaurus lived in a restricted geographic range with a more southern distribution during the late Cretaceous, and it may have been a species that was introduced from South America. Now, overall, sauropods were a remarkably successful group of dinosaurs. And despite their gigantic sizes, they lived for an enormous long period of time, over 100 million years. So this is amazing, given how big these creatures were, to have them lasting longer than primates or rodents have been on this earth. They were not just an evolutionary oddities, but they were truly a successful group of dinosaurs, and we should show them an incredible amount of respect for this. These were the great giants of the Earth's ancient past. All right, you should now be able to summarize the members of the sauropoda and how to distinguish them from other groups of dinosaurs.